Anyway, so tomorrow I'm not going to be live because I might go live. I mean, when Chile One will be performing, I'm sure I will go live at one point when Chile One will be performing. I'll be at East Park. I mean, I've been talking about this because I strongly believe that we need to support our artists. We need to support them. We need to support the comedians. We need to support those who are doing, the actors, you know, those who are doing movies, these guys who are singing songs. We need to support them. We have to support these people so that, we can be entertained. It's nice to listen to these songs, but these songs don't just fall, you know. They have to work on them. They have to go into the studio. They have to be creative. They have to, come up with a team and so on and so forth. All that is an expense. And if we want that music to continue coming, we need to support these guys. They need to see benefit of being, a comedian, a musician, an actor, what else there's whatever it is that is in art. They need to see the benefit. They need to sustain their lives through that. If they don't, we will not have it, and then we will be spending money to import entertainment, which is not good. So let us support our local team. Don't just download these songs and hear. I was playing these songs, and these songs are online. You know, how are they going to go online if nobody pays for them? So please, for just being patriotic, buy the ticket. Buy a ticket for somebody. Let them, get the benefit for being artists. So I'm really supporting Chile One. He's a very good musician, and I know tomorrow it's not only Chile One that will perform. He will also have other musicians that will back him up. So don't think that you're just going to watch Chile One. It is a cocktail of musicians. There will be a number of musicians that will back Chile One on the stage. So please come there and just get entertained. Enjoy the entertainment. I will be there myself. I'm just going to be so ngawanku manyakuria, not if you are shan shan ba president whatever. If you come bona ni staunji shibe. I just want to be myself and enjoy myself, dance, whatever. Not if you are kulikisha sana, let's just go and enjoy. Give him which time enjoy, not if you are kulalishawa neno. So my don kabakuri Chile One by East Park enjoying myself. Naimwe tukakumanekula. Let's meet there. Let's enjoy ourselves. And the next big function, we all know the next big function is the one to fill up the stadium. Here acquire your maps. Please, let's be there. Let's go and fill up that stadium. Kofi Olomide to alimutamba sana. We have watched Kofi Olomide from, I don't know, whatever. Some of you were not even yet born. Kofi Olomide was performing. This time around, it is time that we support our own. So, kuri Kofi Olomide, ngakutimu wako anisha, you can go there. But don't waste all the money on the 26th. Make sure you reserve some money so that on the 27th, Chikari Lemu Independence Stadium, I will also be there. And I'm hoping that by then, my wife would have come back. We can be together, and watch Yo Maps. Remember, we danced to Yo Maps' song, Finally. Naipe Zambabu Yanga, finally. Pawedding. So it will be nice, to go and watch him. So that's that. Please, tomorrow, let us meet at East Park. I'm not going to be talking. So let me get to the issues of today, of tonight. The first thing that I want to talk about is to make a clarification. What are my findings on what the minister said? Yesterday, the defense minister, we called the defense minister and he responded. And he made these points. Number one, he said the list will come out. He couldn't commit when it will come out, but at least he confirmed to say it will come out, contrary to some of the rumors that were saying that were no, people have already gone, the list will not come out. The minister said the list will come out. The other thing that the minister spoke about was that there are no people that are doing training. There are no people that are doing training. This is what he said. The third point was that they can't release the list and then people start waiting, because that will not be good for our security. When the list come out, immediately those people must go into training. So at the moment, they are working on preparing the schools where these people are supposed to go. They are preparing the schools and other logistics where these people will go, such that when the list come out, these people will immediately go into training. This is what the minister said. However, some people came on this program and said that no, actually there are people that are doing training. There are people that are doing training. And one particular barrack which was mentioned was Mufrila. That in Mufrila, they have actually started the training. I think another one mentioned another area, I don't know, but it came out emphatically that the minister was lying, the minister was not sincere, people have actually started doing this. Generally, people were skeptical of his statement. Generally, people were skeptical of his statement. They thought he was lying. I did my investigation. Starting from last night, I made a few phone calls, and some people actually did volunteer. Some people did volunteer information. They sent me information about that issue, as to whether the minister was lying, as to whether there are people that have already started training. And I want to tell you that from last night and today, I have spoken to a number of people, and very credible people, not praise singers, credible people. I wish I could mention them, but I can't. These people have confirmed to me that what the minister said is true. What the minister said is true. And equally myself, I have come to, I'm convinced that what the minister said is true. Now, I know some of you, we like to form opinions. When we form an opinion, regardless of what we are told, we don't want to accept it, unless whatever is said conforms to whatever opinion that we have formed in our minds. But from my point of view, I don't think that is a good way. That is the best way we should approach national issues. I think if we are going to approach national issues, let us be honest. The same way that we are demanding other people to be honest with us, let us also be honest. And let us also be gracious, if I could use that word. Let us be objective. Let us be objective. Let us not just start looking, fight to look for negative when there is no negative. I don't think that is good, and that is not my approach. My approach to life, it doesn't matter whether I like you or I don't like you, but I want to be truthful and I want to be objective. So, much as there are emotions, there is impatience. Yeah? There is impatience on this matter. Let us be objective. Let us be truthful. And the truth is in what the minister said. This is not about me favoring the minister. If I had found, out of my investigation, if I had found something contrary to what he told me, I would have come back here and bashed the minister. I would have come here and bashed the minister, believe me. I mean, I haven't met him. I've seen he's in the northern part of Zambia. I think some of you who have watched the news, you even saw him on news. Today he went to see my Chitimukulu, which is also true, because he told me to say I couldn't pick the call because I'm out of Lusaka and I'm attending to some functions. And clearly we have seen him on the news that he's out of Lusaka. So he was right. In terms of, to say the list is going to come out, yes, I've spoken to some people that have actually been part of that process. Except those who have been part of that process, they have mentioned that some people, especially senior government officials, were bringing a list of people who were not part of those people who were lining up. This, they have told me, that some people brought papers of people that were not part of those who were lining up. But they have confirmed to me that, yes, the list is there and it is yet to be released. Except this part where some government, senior government ministers or some senior government officials brought names of people that were not part of the people that gathered, which is very bad. And unfortunately, I don't know. But let us be on the lookout. If it is possible for some of you, because some of these people come from our communities. So if you know that a particular individual, when you were lining up, he was not even maybe in Zambia, or he was doing something else, he was not there. If you see them on the list, let us expose them. Let us be on the lookout when that list will come out. Let us be on alert to see some of those people that we may be convinced that these people were not part of the people that were lining up. But the list is there and it will come out. That is confirmed. What about the issue of people doing training? I am convinced there are no people that are doing training. For the security of those who told me, I can't give much details, but there are no people that are doing training. Yes, there are some people who are waiting to join those that will start training, but they are not a training. And what I was told, the explanation is that, you know, there are those people that are employed, civilian workers in the army. Civilian workers in the army, civilian workers in ZAF, civilian workers in ZNS. Now, these people who work in as civilians, at some point, they are also considered to join the army or the men in uniform, if I could put it in general like that. They are also considered. Just like, for example, we have people that work in the bank. Eh? In the banks, we usually have guards. We have these guards and some people that help in the bank. And you realize that a number of those people that have worked with banks for a long time as a guard, they are sometimes employed to become bankers. They start working for those banks. Even in other companies, it happens. Somebody who is a guard is elevated and is taken over by the company, either as a cleaner or whatever, they are taken on. So, in Mufrila particularly, there are some people that work in the military as civil engineers or civil engineers, let me put it that way. Some are bricklayers, some are plumbers and whatever. So some of these people were considered to be part of the recruitment that happened last. Not this one, but that happened before. So some people were taken. Unfortunately, midway, as they were training, there came some tasks which they were supposed to do. And they were removed from the training to go and attend to those tasks, such as a bridge has fallen, or some houses need to be constructed. And so they were taken off because they were already workers. And unfortunately, they couldn't finish the training. So their friends finished the training, and for them, when they came back, they are still workers. They are workers, but civilians. So now, when they finish that work, it's like, I mean, what do you do? You can't send them back home and just ignore them. No, they have taken them and they have brought them to Mufrila. They are already working. They are already working for the army, but as civilians. And they started the training, but they didn't finish. And since they didn't finish, they cannot, you know, commission them as soldiers. No, they can't. They haven't finished the training. They were stopped midway to go and do some work. And they went, did that work, and they have been brought back. They have been brought back. And these people, these are the ones who are doing the training to catch up, because their friends have already gone. And they are not many. The number is, I know the number, but I will not mention the number. Anyway, let me mention, the number is just 25. There are 25 people at Mufrila right now. And these are civilian workers who have been working with the Defense Force for some time. They started the training, but midway, because of some activities that came, they were taken off to go and attend to those duties. After they finished the duties, their friends have already finished. But for them, they haven't completed. So they are in Mufrila right now. So those are the people somebody from this forum said, there are people in Mufrila that are doing training. There are those, yes, they are there, but that is the situation. It is not those who were being recruited. No, it is not. It is not. Apart from that, there is also in other areas like in Imbala, I was told. In Imbala, for example, there are those, in military, there is continuous training. There is continuous training. So there are some people that are actually doing training, but they are already soldiers. It is continuous training. Continuous training. They need to, you know, to specialize maybe in one thing and so on and so forth. So there are also those. They are not part of those people that were on the queue. That were on the queue in October. No. But there are people that have been selected to do, certain training. Not recruits per se. No. The other one, which relates to the police, they are, at the moment, the police, because they are preparing for the people to come, the police have also taken a number of police officers. They are training them as instructors. They are training them as instructors. So some of them, you may see them even at Lilai, and they are doing training like they are recruits. No, they are not recruits. They are police officers already, but they are training to come and be instructors. Now, when you are being an instructor, you may have to do the same training of the people that you are going to train. Yes, you may have gone through it, but some of the drills may be exactly what the recruits are going to be doing. For example, running. You need to keep fit yourself as an instructor, because you will run with them. You will run with them. So you need to keep fit. So before they come, you need to do those drills to keep yourself fit. So they are those who are training. They are already officers, preparing themselves for those recruits that will come. In a nutshell, I can tell you that I have gone far and wide to the almost to the highest to seek answers. And even below, because those who are on top, they might not tell you the truth. But I've also gone to those ordinary officers. And ordinary officers, they have now ndengirira mwapa chimuntu maro chikesera that yo achami at mutiny. It's not whatever. But anyway, the information is there. It is clear that this is not true. It's not true what people are saying, that people have gone for training. No, it is not true. The list will come out, and at the moment, there are preparations in to prepare for those people that will come in. 5,000 are supposed to be taken in, so they are preparing for them. Please, yes, we need to be critical. We need to be critical, but we need to be truthful. We need to be objective. It's not just to say because, we are in opposition, whatever. I want to be the Messiah. I want to be shown, to be seen as a brave person. It's better to be truthful. It's better to be truthful. Let us bash the government where they are wrong. Let us bash them. Like I want to bash them on a number of issues. You know, I want to start with the Baba police. The issue yaba Stade Moale. The issue of Stade Moale. You know, I am very disappointed, like I said in the morning. I'm very disappointed, number one, on the fact that in the way that they arrested Stade Moale. I'm talking about this because it is becoming a habit for the police officers to catch you like a criminal, like a common criminal, you know, when you least expect it. I mean, we are not criminals. We are not criminals. There is no way, there is no need for the police to be following us and arresting us in a manner that they arrested Stade Moale. But even myself, remember how they arrested me in Livingstone. The police had to move all the way from here, going to Livingstone. For what? I was coming back in the country. I never went to South Africa to go and stay. I never ran away. I came back and the police were all over. They swung into action like they are arresting a rebel leader in Livingstone. I mean, that was not necessary. It is the same thing that I'm seeing with this Stade Moale, the way they arrested him. It was not necessary. I mean, Stade Moale, you just needed to call him. You needed to send a call out. Why not just send a call out? And on that very day, yesterday, when you arrested him, Stade Moale was in court. Was in court. Why didn't you approach him when he was at court and ask him to come to force headquarters? Why did you have to start following him up? It is not good. The second issue is the way, why are you taking us in far police offices? Why? Why are you taking us far? Why did you take Fred Stade Moale to Balmoral? Why? For what? I mean, why not put him in the police cells around here where he can be accessed by the families? This is not good. I mean, I, for one, you have taken me everywhere. Eh? You have taken me far and close, far and near. Why? It is not good. It shouldn't be. And then even some of these cases, but police, don't be used. Don't be used. And even when these cases are coming up, investigate. Investigate. Iria case yakwa Stade Moale, ni brought in dead. That case ni brought in dead. You can't take that case into court and win it. You can't. Unless you are ignorant of the technology that is going on. My voice, this voice that I'm talking about, that you are hearing, it can be imitated. It can be imitated up to 99%, such that when you hear the voice, you would have no doubt that this is Shirifa Tayari. You would have no doubt. And yet it is not me. And it is not just the voice. It is not just the voice. People have, technology has advanced to an extent that you can actually be seeing me right now, like the way you are seeing me. I'm talking. You are seeing. This is Shirifa Tayari. My voice properly. Everything proper. And yet it is not me. It is fake. So when you are arresting Stade Moale, to say, no, this is your voice. Are you sure? You can go and prove that this is his voice. Considering the technology that is there today. And it is not far. What I'm talking about is not that Fiakumuru, Fiaku Heaven. No. You just have to Google it. I simply Googled and I can show you. I have already Googled one. I want to show you. So that Mumone, whoever, technology has advanced. This is Obama there. Eh? This is Obama. And you see? Have you seen fake video? Eh? Do the team behind Smartick Obama think we should be worried about fake videos? Now, look here.
This is Obama. As you probably know, have you seen that reading? As you probably know, this is former US President Barack Obama. Now, and you see, now we can have BBC News. Why, Mona? Now, Mona, can you read? Fake Obama created using AL video 2, BBC News. Why, Mona? Ila Mona kabu ino kuno sana. White House, government. Why, Mona? Everything looks good here. Eh? Look. Boom.
Thinking about my full-time employees and their ability to survive on $8 an hour in New York City. And foremost in all of our minds has been the loss and the grief.
But you have seen here, but this is not, this footage is faked. About Obama.
Held by the people of Orlando. Most of us don't get our
That's
employees.
How they make it.
And what you should know is that, thanks to the Affordable Care Act, your coverage is better today than it was before. Women can get free checkups, and you can't get charged more just for being a woman.
You see?
He and his employees come together to pass a commoner's bill that would boost America's very, very hard times.
Some progress, at least within the small confines of the legal community. I think it's real important.
Here we go.
Look at this imitation. Look at this imitation. Look at how this guy. This guy is the one who is talking, but the voice that is coming is that of Obama, and he's talking this side, but it's this guy talking. Look.
When you give a speech, make sure you use a lot of pauses.
America's businesses have created 14 point.
So, imwe va kapokola. Eh? Na vena nani kane, atishani uyu. Uyu aku cyber. We work cyber bomb and there is a friend, there is a very good friend of mine who works cyber. Don't you know about this? Don't you know about these kind of things? Don't you know? Do you read, you guys? Do you research? Before you go and arrest somebody, you should be very thorough. I can assure you. You will go and stand in court, you embarrass yourself. How are you going to prove that a voice note that appeared is a voice note of Steady Mwale? Because if I want, actually, Steady Mwale, if you hire me, I can create 10 voice notes, different ones. When a police officer will go and stand there, Steady Mwale, all you need to do is to create 10 fake. You make 10 voice notes and put one which is real and ask a police officer to say, can you identify which one is real? That is how you do it. I'm giving free consultants to you, Steady Mwale. Uripide. You should bring money. I can make you 10, nakupangirama voice notes. Pa in your voice, pa 10, and then you put a police officer there, then play those voice notes and say, choose which one is real. Let's see if they will be able to prove. So that case is BID. It's brought in dead. It can't sustain you. You can't in this technology unless you have a witness who was there to say, yes, I was there when he was recording. I was there. Because even me, some of these cases that you bring before me, I'm a man that stands with on what I say. Otherwise, some of these cases I will even refuse. If I want, I can even delete my Facebook page. Hey, you said this on your Facebook page. You said this on your Facebook page. I can create 10 Chirifatayari Facebook pages and post there and ask you which one is the real one, Chirifatayari. Which one? And how sure are you that whatever I said has not been manipulated? Because the way, and you like even holding on to phones. I don't know why you like holding on to phones. I mean, it just shows how dull you are. I'm telling you, this is being dull. It is being dull. I am a phone more democrata. In a misekafi, I just laugh at you because you can never prove. You can never prove. Right now, I'm live. You can't prove that I'm using this phone. You can't. You rely on IPs, but IPs change. IPs change. You think that, no, this was whatever. If in Delanda, it is being uploaded somewhere else. Somewhere else. So how can you confirm that whatever I've said here, it is stored exactly as I have sent it there? How? You know, some of these cases, mitambafie, but really, it's neither here nor there. How? Nganaisa I can in a video on Delanda pwe. Tomorrow I can denounce it to say, no, it's not me. How are you going to prove that indeed, what you are downloading is exactly the way I did it? How? Because it can be manipulated. You are going to download what I said from another source. From another source. And that source could have manipulated that. Ndiye nifunda. Mna isa ku refresher course. Cyber, whatever. Mna isa ku kuma mwanjitako. You know, mka pange conference, mwanjita. Nke semi langa ko some of these things. Na mifundako. Because really, you show serious incompetence. Tumire kafe, mirole lafe. Some of these cases, and hey, tayari apologize, what? Kule kafe ata, you know. Otherwise, if I want to refuse, I can refuse. But the thing is that I don't refuse to say it's me because, I mean, I believe in what I say. But if I want to be technical, I can be technical that I would lose all of you. Mwewa kusai, boku yuka kofena, bada weneva boss we nubadi. Uku mirufia, kutina mirufia, I can confuse you. But I'm a man that stands by my word. What I say, I stand by it. But technically, ngandefo kufipenya, kutina afipenya, technically. So, muna chula fi, mule njikatira mafoni, na mune njikatira mafoni, na ambo kulafu ama foni ya chipa, and yet ni nkwata mafoni ya mtengo. Imwana muikata, at evidence. Tuka mimona, ndelo lela. Mukese wino, awaku cyber security, mukese wino, that we have found evidence in this phone. Na lole sha. I'm telling you. Mulanzekesha, bad. Now we got a phone. Phone, we get it. Imitamuni na data, but now we got it here. Atimuni evidence. Muni evidence, chifoni tamuni finimu. Mulanda wisha. Anyway, Chien, let's go. So, I guess I was that one. So it has the case I was the one. Not second when I heard about what. Anyway, so that is that on state one. But anyway, I'm glad that you gave him bond. He's out on bond, which is good. But I mean, taking to court, whoever has sent you, those are cases that you should just put aside. Otherwise, Mukala seva nyafe, and you are wasting the court's time. Instead of the court to be looking at serious cases, they will be looking at cases that cannot go anywhere. Anyway, having clarified that, I mean, let's go now to Vahaka Inde Ichirema. You know, Vahaka Inde Ichirema, you see, he has put in people that fear, and people are trying to do whatever it is to impress Vahaka Inde Ichirema, such that here it is, tomorrow there will be a memorial to mark his birthday, and there will be a function at the graveyard. And now you have made that program, and you have put a picture of Vahaka Inde Ichirema. There is nowhere where there is a picture of KK. Honestly, how? How? I know it is not Vahaka Inde Ichirema who is preparing those documents, but it is because this is how they perceive a president. They have perceived Vahaka Inde Ichirema that is one person who wants to be praised. He one person who wants to be glorified. Eh? So people are not working independently. They are trying so hard to impress Vahaka Inde Ichirema. They are trying so hard to impress Vaka in the HDM. They want Vaka in the HDM to be everywhere. To be everywhere. If they can...
anyway, ni landefia vlogulondoroka.
But they want to print Vaka in the HDM in everything. In everything, they want Vaka in the HDM. I think in a toilet, no mango ingram toilet, we will end up finding the picture of Vaka in the HDM. Because this is how he has portrayed himself. He wants to be seen everywhere. It is all about him. This country is his. Everything, it's about him. Whatever the name of Vaka in the HNM should go on it. The picture of Vaka in the HNM should go on it. This is not good. This is not good at all. That cabinet, it is cabinet that made that mistake. That mistake, it's a big mistake. You can't have a memorial. Where did you have, you know, a memorial? You go to even the graveyard and the picture of the person of the deceased is not anywhere. How? Why are you putting Aka in the HNM? Is he the one who died? Or tomorrow, is it his birthday? What is the picture of Aka in the HNM got to do with that? This is a national function. What is the portrait of Aka in the HNM doing there? What is it doing? What is it doing? What is the relationship? It is a national function. So now the nation is equal to Aka in the HNM. Everything is about Aka in the HNM. It is a mess. It is really a mess. It is a shame. It is a shame. And you people at the cabinet office, I mean, you need to realize that you are there to save the Zambian people. You are not there to save Aka in the HNM. Yes, he's the president. You are supposed to, you know, respect him and take the orders from him, but not to impress him, not to go out of your way to impress Aka in the HNM. That is not your job. Your job is to impress the Zambian people, not Aka in the HNM. You are messing it up. Like you have messed up. You also messed it up when that Kamala Harris was coming. You went printed those if my billboards, Aka in the HNM. Nakamwala Hairisuku. When President Aka in the HNM is a president, Kamwala Hairis is a vice president. So you can't put them together. I mean, is it that the people who know the job at government office are not there? There are so many things that are actually going wrong in terms of protocols. In terms of protocol, there is a mess. And this is what happens when you are putting cadres. When you are putting cadres, this is what happens. There is a mess in terms of protocol. But come on. Let us respect our government and let us follow the protocols that are there. Not the way mle woman chipante pante chipante pante kwati mnipa market. Na pa market pala wako protocol. Pala wa market chairman na wa shanshan yuko wala wapo. Pala wako order. There is no order in the government. There is no order. That's why you even have that Beijing, the bodyguard from Beijing. The bodyguard from Beijing is nowhere in the government structure. It's not there. But presidency is an institution. President is an institution with prescribed personnel and functions. Bodyguard from Beijing is nowhere. It is very clear that Vaka in the HNM doesn't trust his bodyguard. He trusts the bodyguard from Beijing. Bodyguard from Beijing is the one that sits in front. Is the one that sits in front. Is the one that opens the vehicle. Why is it that why is it that the protocol prescribes that the driver should be a police officer and the bodyguard should be a police officer? The one to open the door should be a police officer. Do you know why it is like that? It is part of security. Vaka in the HNM is a national asset who is supposed to be carried by our police. It is the police, the welfare of Vaka in the HNM. The security of Vaka in the HNM is in the hands of the state. It is the police to protect Vaka in the HNM. It is the police to sit in front, guarding the president, not a bodyguard from Beijing. Where did he do his training to protect the president? Where did he do the training? Eh? Mukatwebe, tell us if that man was trained somewhere to look after the president. Because those that guy who is sitting in front, he just doesn't sit there in front in our president. He's supposed to be conscious. He's supposed to sense danger. They are supposed to be coordinating with the driver and the other officers on the convoy. That is the job of that guy. That guy is supposed to be talking to other officers. Oh, our president Valwala. Oh, let's change the route. Let us go this way. Let us do this. That is the job of a bodyguard. Number one, a bodyguard from Beijing. Elchita commandi, yonse convoy. If there is danger, that police officer who sits in front with the police, with the president behind, is the one that says, no, let's change the route. Instead of going this route, let us go this route. And he communicates with others. So who communicates with others in terms of, you know, the movement? Who communicates? Because that bodyguard, Tabamumuriba president, if something happens, God forbid, if something happens in that vehicle, who is going to explain? Because the job of a driver is to drive the vehicle, not to be looking after the president. No. Not to be looking after the president. It is the bodyguard, this guy. How are we going to hold that civilian? How are we going to hold him accountable if anything happens to our president? How are we going to hold him accountable? When that bodyguard comes out, before he opens the door, he makes sure that the president is safe. It is right for him to open. It is not just a matter of bowing and you open the door. No. But fiance, if you are aka in the Ichirima, I mean, he's a man that, you know, is so big-headed, he's so incorrigible. It is just him, that's it. Whatever we say, it doesn't matter. No, our president, Mule Ikaramu State House, it doesn't care. We know our president, be protected by the people that are supposed to protect the president. He doesn't want. He doesn't want. That is not good, our president. It is not good, Ndemieva. It is not good. It is not good for you. It is not good for our country. Ndemieva Kofi. It is not good. What the way you are carrying your presidency is not good for our country. Is not good for you. It's not good for you. We have people now that are being knocked down to death. They are being knocked down to death. Because you are stubborn, you just want to be going to community house. And you are risking so many people because you are the president. Come on, Tefo Chava. You should humble yourself. You are elected by the people. You are elected by the people. You should humble yourself. You can't be so arrogant. You can't be so big-headed. As if you want to turn Zambia as if it is your Kantemba. That you can do whatever you want. No. There are rules that are supposed to be followed. There is a decorum that is supposed to be followed. There is protocol that is supposed to be followed. Imwe fiance fe, you are thrown in the gutter because you are president. You are at in the Ichirim. So it doesn't matter. No, no. That's not how we elected you. Zambian people didn't elect you to be so arrogant, to be so big-headed, to be so egocentric. No. No. And Mune Chitefyo, kwat palinefo Mune Chita deliver. You are so big-headed, you are so arrogant, and yet, what are you delivering? What are you doing? Look at today. All you are doing, mass speeches. Eh? I mean, do you even listen to yourself, Baka in the Ichirima? Do you listen to yourself? The speeches you make, do you listen to yourself? That's why I say it is a mental condition. Seriously. That's why I say it is a mental condition because takwa omuntula and defintu. I mean, you say things that really are like, come on. The other day you were saying this. You are so inconsistent. So inconsistent. So incoherent. I can't understand you, our president. With due respect. I can't understand you, our president. I can't understand you. Today, that's that nice speech you are making. I want to play that speech so that people can hear, and we are going to go through it. We are going to go through that speech. I recorded it. I want us to go through that speech that you made, which is making rounds on social media and in traditional media. Now, as ZNBC, the president has said, let's say on the GX, let us be prudent. Hey, we are supposed to pay debt. Waka in the ichinema. Hey, you, civil servants, mulenda in the sana. Hey, I'm tired of firing people. Waka in the ichinema. Waka in the ichinema. Let us be real. Let us look at what he said so that we can go through it and analyze what he said. There we are. So this was a news item.
As directed that all brand new Land Cruiser VX vehicles bought under UPND full coverage must be sold and revenue invested in productive areas that will create jobs. The president says buying luxury vehicles when government is trying to sort out the debt is not prudent utilization of resources. Addressing a leadership workshop for the presidential delivery unit in Osaka today, President Hichilema also observed that some ministers and cabinet secretaries are perpetually traveling, yet their performance is below par. Brian has the details.
Ministers, federal secretaries, and other senior government officials have gathered for a leadership workshop for the presidential delivery unit, PDU. President Hakainde Hichilema is the key guest at the workshop for units keeping monitoring and pushing for delivery of government projects. With key targets set, such as delivery of destined schools before the end of this year, complete elimination of load shedding and growing the economy. President Hichilema wants these public officers to reflect on their delivery levels.
Just ask yourself where you sit, the way you conduct yourself. Have you contributed something tangible that you can point at that since I got this fair privilege to say, what have I delivered for that person who voted for us? What have you done as minister in your ministry to change for the better? We were elected on the ticket of change. I'm tired of swearing in people. I want us to deliver.
With commitment made on cutting down public expenditure, the president wants all high-value vehicles that were bought after assuming office in 2021 sold and invested in productive sectors.
We agree that expenditure extravagance is not part of us. What do I say? You are still applying to buy new VXs, Senator Cabinet. Anyone who has bought a VX in central government, in local government, in quasi-government decisions, I would like an instruction which will be followed up to bring out those VXs, put them in the market and sell them.
The president also called for unity among government workers in carrying out their duties while urging the government to grant the PDU access in their offices.
Especially if you're in the BSC, you have an opportunity to make a change. But I hear you now create friendships amongst Director A, Director B, those who know how to reward you properly when you travel. The directors that remind you that there is work to be done. I'm not good directors. Let's support the delivery unit. The delivery unit will work with you as colleagues, respectively. Make the delivery unit redundant by getting a job done.
So, that is our president. I'm sure you have heard him loud and clear. You have heard him loud and clear. Now, he makes a number of statements. He's challenging his ministers and PSs. He's saying, what have you done? What have you done, you know, for the people that voted for UPND? I can ask that question to Hakainde Hichilema himself. Hakainde Hichilema, you are the head of state. You are the leader. You are the leader. These guys that you are talking about, that you are challenging and everything, they look at you. They look at you. They read your foot. Which way are you going? And they act according to what they think is what you want. You are the leader. But you are failing. You are failing and you want to blame others. This is not the first time that you are blaming your civil servants. Even before you said you blame the civil servants. That there are people who are dragging us. You know, we are going to flush them out. How did the civil servant sabotage a CDF? How? Who made the rules? Who made the policy? Who made the policy? The CDF, because CDF is a disaster, it has failed. Who made the policy? It is you and your people. It is you. Cabinet approved how CDF must be spent. Some of us, we complained. And you never listened. Now, CDF is a disaster. It is a disaster. Last year, CDF is a disaster. People did not access your CDF. That money has not been seen because that money did not reach the people. It didn't. This year we are talking, this is April, is finishing. There is no CDF. Are you telling me it is the civil servants that are sabotaging? Are you telling me that? Is it the civil servants that have sabotaged that? The free education that you talk about, you are talking about desks. I mean, there is much more that is needed to support that free education. There is much more. Basically, with your CDF, you are giving 200 per child for a term. 200. And you are not giving all children. Because education is also divided. And you are only giving a portion of that. 200 per child. Now, 200, do you think 200 can sustain a child in school for a term? This is real, and these numbers. I'm not just talking about 200. No, that is the money that you are giving to schools. You are giving 200 per child. Now, 200, can a child be sustained for a term with 200 kwacha? What I'm looking at, I'm saying, I mean, the teachers need something to write, whether chalk or whiteboard. They need reams of paper. They need reagents, those who are doing sciences and everything. It can't sustain. Is it the civil servants that made that policy? It is not. You are challenging these people. What have you done? What have you done? What have you done? What about you, Baaka in the HLM? You are challenging those people. Me, I'm challenging you. I'm challenging you, Baaka in the HLM. What have you done? What have you done? 1 year, 7 months as president. What have you done? You promised so many things. What have you achieved? Apart from making things worse, you promised the Zambian people you are going to reduce the bag, food price, commodity prices. A bag of mealie-meal will be 50 kwacha. You promised them. What have you done? Baaka in the HLM. You have put the bag of mealie-meal now to 250. Baaka in the HLM. You promised the Zambian people you are going to bring a fuel price to 12 kwacha, 10 kwacha. At most, it will be 12 kwacha. Where have you taken the price of fuel? You are good at talking. And especially your Bazungu friends. So now they have taken those pictures and they are throwing them globally. This is a very good president. He's performing. What performance have you achieved, Baaka in the HLM? What have you achieved? You promised I'm going to give fertilizer at 250 kwacha. What have you done, Baaka in the HLM? Electricity has been increased. You promised young people jobs. Where are the jobs? You promised young people empowerment. Where is empowerment? What have you done? What have you done, Baaka in the HLM? For you to have the audacity of challenging these people to say, what have you done? Ask yourself that question. You alluded to that date to say every day I'm talking to them and whatever, whatever. Remember what you said when you just came in. Me, within a short time, I've managed the IMF. What have you done? Where is the IMF? Hey, UPPF should consult us, should engage us to do debt restructuring. That's what you were saying, Waka Indeichile. You were offering yourself to be hired to do debt restructuring. But PF, they don't need to hire people to do debt restructuring. They should just come to us. We will do it. What have you done, Waka Indeichile? What have you done? So when you are challenging others, look at yourself first. Don't just be a good speaker. Don't just be a good speaker. Be a pragmatic person. You aren't that pragmatic person. You are a rhetorist. Just talking, lying. That's all. So really, I mean, I was looking at that and these things I'm saying, these things are real. These things are truthful. These things are truthful. Civil servants, I will increase your salaries and I'll give you partial whatever, whatever. Imwe 20% nishinge shomule fola. Nishinga mule fola. Where is the money? Partial payment is becoming like a big thing, like whatever, whatever. Nishinga mule fola. Nishinga. How much are you getting? Imagine a person that is getting 2,000 kwacha per month. 2,000 kwacha per month. 2,000 kwacha per month. He saves NAPSA every month because it's 10%, 5%, 5%. 5% from him, 5% from the employer. 10%, which is 200. 200 in a month, in a year. How much does one save? 2,400. 2,400 in a year. 2,400 if you have worked for 5 years. If you have worked for 5 years, how much? That is 12p. 12,000, because we're talking about 60 months. That's why I'm saying five years. 60 months for you to claim. So in 5 years, you would have saved 12,000. What is 20% of 12,000? What is 20% of 12,000? What is 20% of 12,000? It's 2,400. 2,400. Ewe mkutanta minoko. To get 2,400. And I've used 2,000 because many people are getting that much. Many people are getting that much. Even if you double that. Even if you double that, basically, you are talking about 4,800. On average, we can say people are walking, are going away with just about 4,500. On average. That is actually on the higher side. I think we would even be talking about 3,000, whatever. So your 3,000, MPA Mulela and Apatio, it is going to settle your debts because civil servants were excited about this partial payment. It came as a result of the debt that they had. So nga umuntu nga fola, let's say nurses, teachers, they are getting, let's say, even 5,000. Is 5,000 going to be enough to go and pay the microfinance that they owe? No. So there is nothing that we should be getting excited about. Nothing. Then you go ahead and start saying, hey, I'm tired of swearing. I'm swearing people. Basically, you are saying, I'm tired of firing people. You know, I fire this one, I hire whatever, whatever, whatever. I mean, look at your ministers. You have just been touching ama PSS. You are not touching your ministers. Look at Vasilvia Masebo. Look at Vasilvia Masebo. Look at who you are, the Mokusaba, he'll show you. Minister of Agriculture. Look at Minister of Labor, Batambatamba. Batambatamba, you are there as Minister of Labor. Kuzesko, just Kuzesko. Mwalifumia new nanikan. You have a new wage, a minimum wage. You have not even sensitized people. People don't even know about the new minimum wage. They don't know. And we have a company, quasi-government, Zesco. People are getting 1.5 in Zesco. Batambatamba namwikaloko mleshipula mu office. Kuzesco, just kuzesco there. People are getting 1.5. National airport, in government too. People are being given yama contracts. Umuntu alibomba 25 years. Bampela contract ya every year. Come and get paid. Ale for a 2 pin. And yet you promise these people that you are going to sort out this mess. If you can't sort out, even just people, our possessor, you can't sort out. National Airport Corporation, you can't sort out. Men in uniform, nshaikateko. But now nishiba. Men in uniform, nshaikateko. Mairo mke sati yo mutiny. But now, that should send a message to you. Men in uniform. So, What are you talking about? You are failing to kick out ministers who are not performing. You are failing. And you are saying you are tired. You are tired of what? You are tired of doing nothing. You are tired of doing nothing, Waka in the Ichirema. You are tired of doing nothing. I'm telling you. You are tired of doing nothing. No, extravagancy. Extravagancy. Let's start with yourself. When you went to be sworn in, you went nakalaka moto kalaka white. And you came out like that is the kind of life that you want to lead. That is how you came out. I remember when you were a president-elect, they sent vehicles to your house. They sent vehicles to community house. And you turned them away. No, I don't want these big cars. And the praise singers were all over social media. Haka in the HMA. He has refused new cars. He has turned them. He doesn't want them. But haka in the HMA, are you driving the same vehicles that President Edgar Lungu was driving? Because all the 4x4s, you have changed them. You are driving a Lexus, which are in the same range of the GXs. New ones. You are driving new vehicles back in the HLM. We see this. You have changed. Back in the HLM. Remember back in the HLM. Forevermore. We follow these things. You used to say, no extravagancy. My ministers will not be flying first class. That's what you used to say. My ministers will not be flying first class. Including myself, Baraka in the Ichirem. How have you been flying? Now you have even started hiring vehicles, planes. You are hiring planes and you are refusing to use a plane that we have already bought. And yet you go and hire because you are giving business to your friends. We know these things. You are refusing to use a plane that we have already bought. You are giving business to your friends. You are hiring planes. But yet you are saying, no, Ina, don't even mind flying economy. No, business class. You are flying business class. Your ministers are flying business class. You don't know? Are you going to say you don't know? Eh? But because you are this, you know, good liar, good sweet talker, you sit and talk about it. No extravagancy. You said this, it's not new. But have you done it? You haven't done it. Your ministers are still flying, you know, business class. They are still, you know, sleeping in expensive hotels. What prudence are you talking about, Baka Indeje? And Baraka in the HLM, you want to turn around now and say they have these ministers, you are moving a lot at globe trotting, PSs and ministers, you are moving a lot. Baraka in the HLM, wakonka imwe, tamwishive. Wakonka imwe. You are the one who is doing globe trotting. But katwishinga chava shani, because some of these things, efendela that katwishinga wuluele. Because, I mean, ufila waishiva, some of these things, te kulanda pofe no kulanda pofe. Imo wa haka inda ichirema, you have been, you are the number one globetrotter. You are number one. You are moving. You have been moving. How many times have you moved? But you want to sit there and lecture others to say, mulenda sana. Wa haka inda ichirema. Mwawashan. How? Eh? You are the number one. Wa haka inda ichirema. You have been moving too much. You have been moving. At mwaleva tete galungwa ite mwendeke. Mama, mama. Hey. Mwaleva tete galungwa ite mwendeke. Ma, waka inde ichirem. Kutu Ebert is a rich man. Eh? Some of us were thinking that, no, he's a rich man. He has whatever. Ma, hey, takapuiririka. Awa takapuiririka. Muni waka inde ichirema mwena. Awa ni mbona. Takapuiririka mdala. Takapuiririka. Ah, karashara. Karashara mdala. Nangu uwe shani shani. Kare karashara mdala. Hey. How one day? Can you never do my kind of chilema? About we never. Eh? Ever never took it and take what can't wish. Mdara and deco like, what eat them on Dara, what eat them all I would to kill her. Ula, you would to kill them Dara, bad. Now pass in Babo Ponsikuya. Dara could take a yakona you. Therefore, I have Mdara. Eh? Even that what's doing you know that is to pende. Let's calculate how much money you have wasted. Pande came over a kind of chilema. Nishinga. The money that you have spent pandeke wa mdala kutitu alipira kone nkongole kutitu alipira ko mwalite mwendeke wa mdala eh atishani mchitonga tole shanani eh mula ijana atishani mwalite mwa how do you say mwalite mwa mchitonga mula itachana mula iyanda. Can somebody tell me how you say it in Tonga? At Mwalite Mwendeke, how do you say it in Tonga? I want to learn Tonga. Can somebody tell me how do you say it? Eh? Achan Mwalite Mwendeke, much Tonga. Mamdala Mwalite Mwendeke, takwa mdala, takwa. Takwa, mdala jamona po president wa te mwendeke kwa tinimweo. You like Ndeke mdala. Eh? Balai yanda. Eh, hey, balai yanda ndeke maningi sumu. Balai yanda, bad kind. Ah, mwandini. Ah, waka inde ichema mwandini. Ndeke na mwalite mwandini wa mdala wa nite timbepe. Mwalite mwa. You like it. Yeah. Takwa wa president wa temu ndekefi. Elo nero mwise mwalu kati. You are grob trotting. Mdala ni mwa wa globetrotter. Eh? Mukafuma na Guinness World Book of Records. Mukafuma. One of the African leaders who atemu ndeke wa haka inde chile ma mukafuma. Because mdala mwa alitemu wa kwenda. Mwa alitemu ndeke bad kind. So stop pretending like you are saving anything. Hmm? And these people that you are talking about to say, no, hey, you are moving too much. You are moving too much. Wa haka inde chile ma. Ama ministers, when they are moving out, just within Zambia, from Lusaka, is in Kasama. If he's in Kasama, he's in the northern part of Zambia. Before a minister moves, the president must authorize. The president authorizes. These people can't move without your authority. So imo waka inde ichirema, mwana pirivu kashani mtambo kwa blema. And yet, you are the one who authorizes. And most of the times, you move with them. So mwana sa pirivu kashani leno. Eh? And ba journalists na wabali excited. How ba president na walanda. Kiri kiti. Hey, headlines. Hey, shan. Mwema journalist na imwe, alanami papata. Mwema critical. Issue ya kula kutafena nikane just repeating, just writing events without any analysis at all is very bad. Because that's what we have. Our journalists are just storytellers. They just narrators. This is what happened. This is what happened. This is what he said. That's it. There is no one that comes to say, he said this, but this. Our journalists, they are just good and they canonize people. They make people, you know, look so nice based on what they say. A few, I'm not seeing journalists that come and say, he said this, but this is what is happening. He said his ministers and PSs are moving too much, but he's the one who carries them. He's the one who moves more than them. No one is able to do that. No one is able to do that. You're not telling him. You write a news. No, they are moving too much. No one is able to write another line to say, but the president is the one who authorizes these ministers to move around. It is you who authorizes. No minister can go outside Lusaka, for that matter. What about outside the country? It is obvious you need to agree. But you want to play smart before the cameras, before your bazungus, that you are a good president. No, Amdala, you are a failure. You are a failure. You are a failure. And just what you are saying, it is confirming your failure. You saying that the ministers are moving a lot, you are confirming that you are not a president who supervises these people properly. Because if you are a president who supervises these people properly, you would not allow them to be moving around. You would not allow them to be flying first class because you said no first class. But you are exposing yourself, except to those who are naive. Who are naive, they are clapping for you. Hey, the president has said this. Some of us will look at you to say, what a president we have. And these are real things. You can hate me for it, but this is real. You said it, Wamdara, no first class. You are the one who authorizes them to go. Eh? So, what are we talking about here? What are we talking about? Who should blame who? Eh? Then let's talk about these GXs. Let's talk about these GXs. These GXs, some people are saying, no, these GXs were bought by PF, whatever. Nonsense. They were bought by UPND. They were bought by UPND. There's nothing like, no, whatever. They were bought by UPND. And even if there was an order, it would be cheaper to cancel an order than what is happening now. Where now you have bought vehicles. Vehicles are in the country. Mwaenda mono kwendamo, and now you say, let's steal them. Mamdala varite muama sampo efida mieva. Where is vaka inde ichilema so much, you know, kuma sampo mamdala, fionsefe kushitisha. Fionsefe kushitisha. Efida mieva, tivaka shiche charo haba. Mukada wafia tawe charo chashupe, chen tuposhi. Vaka shiche charo mamdala. Takwa wa mtu wa temu kushitisha efintu ifi. I can't tuposhi. Dara. Chava shangan, shashami. Kwa liwa mtu wa temu ama sampo efi. Awa mdara mwali, ya temu ama sampo. Ah. Eh, gaf, ah, tuwala posha. Eh, shansha, tuwala posha. Fionzefe kuposha. Everything selling. Chava shani wa mdala. In the first place, those vehicles, those are not matches or inject or inherit. Those are vehicles, expensive vehicles. I mean, we saw a convoy of those vehicles coming into the country. That is a lot of money which was spent. And such a lot of money cannot be spent without you knowing. Unless indeed you are so incompetent that you don't know what is happening in your government. But really, if you have got an ounce of competence, you ought to know about these vehicles. Now, these vehicles are here. And you say, take to Porsche, put them on the market. Privatization, yeah, limito, omuto, amdala. How many should we share privatization? You really felt the juice, the honey in privatization. and you just want to continue with it. But Vamdala, what are you leaving for the country? If you sell everything, what are you going to leave for the children that are growing up? Ngamwa Posha Fionse, what will remain for Zambians if you sell everything? Are there not better ways that you can look at how we can sort out this? Why is it that always the first thing that you think of is Kushtisha, it's Kuposha? Why? These vehicles are already here. Why can't you think of something else? Why can't you think of saying, okay, these vehicles are here. These vehicles are here. Let us withdraw them and keep them at the cabinet office so that we can use them when we have dignitaries. Because when we have big functions and we have a number of presidents, right now we are going to host COMESA, heads of states and whatever. I think we are going to host it very soon. And you know what happens when there are such functions? Government hires vehicles. Government hires vehicles, luxury vehicles. So why can't you think of grabbing those vehicles and put them in a pool to be used when we have big functions, when we have a number of presidents coming? Instead of us going to hire, we can use those vehicles. Why can't you think in those lines? Chashu Pashani. Eh? Imwe, you can't think like that. Kuposha. Indeke kuposha. Imi otoka kuposha. Ama mines kuposha. Companies kuposha. Mangala. Yashani. Land kuposha. Mle posha. Kuma Kenyans. You are posha in there. Fionse kuposha mdana. Why don't you keep those vehicles and use them? Use them in when we have big functions. We at AU, it should have taught us a lesson that we need to have some vehicles that we can be using. Why can't you think in those lines? Ima mulefu ave mposhe. Mulefu ave fionse kuposha mdala. Elonga mwa posha muka shtenu kushita imwewe. Because that's what it is. That is what we know. Eh? You come out and now put them on the market. At the end of the day, we will find you have bought 10 of those vehicles. No. Defo mfilo kuteke chalo efi. Defo mfilo kuteke chalo wa mdala wanti. And if you think then you wa mdala, teko watu kumipata, I'm just opening your eyes to see apa yugulema, I want you to see where there is a weakness. Where there is a sickness. This is a sickness, Vamdala. This is a sickness. Popo sickness. Eh? Ni popo mdala. Ma posha fe. Ni ka popo sickness. Mwa kwa tak. Popo sickness. Kuposha fe. Kula posha fe. Kula. Filifionse kuposha. Wulwelo. We can't go on like that. Those vehicles, don't posha them. Keep them, let us use them when we have government, when we have whatever, let's use them. That Gulf Stream, if you don't want to use it, keep it. There are rich people that can be hiring that plane. We can use it, turn it into commercial. Let's start using it for commercial purposes. There are rich people that will be hiring it. The same way that you are hiring planes from other places, other people will come and hire it as well. Some presidents let's advertise it. Some people will come and will be hiring that plane instead of you selling it. Because when you sell it, you will not sell it at the price at which we bought it. Same with these vehicles. These vehicles, they came as brand new vehicles. But when you sell them, you will not sell them as brand new vehicles. They will be second-hand vehicles. The price will be low. So let us not posture them. Let's keep them. Let's keep our plane. Let's keep the vehicles. Let us not sell them. Therefore, if you look with Charlie, if you, therefore, if you look over, they just cut the cafe away. You don't see the map, good posture. You don't see good posture. However, therefore, if you look over, therefore, if you look over. Now, I'm going to talk about PF, but I think in a lot of Mr. Spear, they're over PF. I'll be on you In my next presentation, whether it will be on Saturday or Sunday, I will talk about you. For now, I think I'll leave it here so that Naimu Mlandeko, you can phone. Where is my phone now? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Where is that phone I use? Let me get the phone that I use. Let me get that phone that I use. Meanwhile, I can leave you listening to this as I'm getting that phone.
So as directed, that all brand new Land Cruiser VX vehicles bought under new PNG Ford coverings must be sold and revenue invested in productive areas that will create jobs. The president says buying luxury vehicles when government is trying to sort out debt is not prudent utilization of resources. Addressing a leadership workshop for the presidential delivery unit in Lusaka today, President Hichilema also observed that some ministers and permanent secretaries are perpetually traveling, yet their performance is below par. Paranoari has the details.
Ministers, permanent secretaries, and other senior government officials have gathered for a leadership workshop on the military and pushing, such as delivery of.
Have you contributed something tangible that you can point at that since I got this film? Privilege to say, what have I delivered?
You voted for us. What have you done as minister in your ministry to change for the better? We were elected on the ticket of change.
Yeah, we have our first caller.
Swearing in people. I want us to
hello? Hear. Hello?
Good evening, my president.
Good evening.
Anyway, thank you for your program. Whatever you say, people understand and get something. Companion po finimulanda, companion po oa kumfwa lomfwa, oa mabatwa kumfwa, oa mpata akasanga mocha mpata pati. We are two for the nation. Please, companion po kafimutete. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Hello?
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 Hello? Following your program, and just like what you said, I have two things that I want to say. And
yes.
Which I'm disappointed with our government and the lead. Munanda, as a family, if your children are spending and you are not monitoring their expenses, you are the number one failure.
Mm-hmm.
The president, what he did today, is not making sense. He's going out there, blaming his ministers, but this is the number one culprit. So when those, I want to follow, and I think I like what you say, our generals, do they follow these stories? So when those cars were being bought, who was authorizing those payments? And then today, that's when they should notice that, no, my ministers are living a very expensive life. So, Mr. President, where has he been for the past 1 year, 7 months? Then my second point is this. I was following the Sean Tembo. And Sean Tembo had a very good point. President, who are we mourning and who are we celebrating? Is it not our late founder president? Why would the president want to showcase his face but he doesn't want to put the president, the founder president of this nation? This also takes me back to say that president, I think, has got people that do not give him proper advice. Because this is the same thing that you said when the visiting American vice president was visiting, we saw a lot of billboards of him and the vice president. Where was our vice president? Why was she not put alongside Kamala? This is also the same thing, like I'll ask the Zambia. We have a president who has decided to stay in community house. He doesn't want to stay in the residential house. And they're just so quiet about that. The performance for me is why we are saying this president he speaks but does not fulfill what he talked about. Today, that was a zero point of him showing his incompetence by trying to blame his minister. Thank you, Mr. Chilufya Kairi. And I've always said, your program is about your opinion. Those people that do not like your opinion, they should not be tuned in and they should not even be saying things to you. You are there. You are brave enough to air out your opinion. So thank you very much.
Where are you calling us from, by the way, before you hang up?
No, I'm calling you from Canada.
Oh, okay. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Hello?
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 Manse?
Yes, my brother.
You're okay?
I'm good. That is Mukosa, right?
Yes. I can imagine.
I've missed you.
Atenze kumafarm kai tipo na kulira na ungamonga stay ona mvula mbona ni sema fare na kuti tilibe kwa mimi nichoka kuti tingalime mimi wazipangira chakudya chako.
Okay, nzato atisi niko na mafarm
tilibe mafarm tena kumunzi kuliba ibe kumunzi Mr. Chirupia.
Oh, okay, go ahead.
Comrade, today I just want to talk about the partial withdrawal, NAPSA's partial withdrawal, which the government, a new Dutton government, has managed to put in place, whereby now people will be getting their money before they retire, 20% before they retire. I think it's a good move, although we have heard our brothers and sisters, other brothers and sisters are saying, no, people become destitute after Wakashita retire. To me, those arguments does not hold water. Because ngatu ulibe 007 sandrama, ulo waendo tenga ulina 70 years, kuzao nonga. But ngatu ulina 007 sandrama, like munga mweno uli retired, you are able to do things. Ukari mufana, it doesn't mean that ukari mufana ukangala na drama then ungaono. Chirupia tayari have been doing things, if amene vakuta ndizira, you have always been boasting to say, nikuwa nisawa kusunga wantu, na kulipiri la wana wanga kusukuru. So what is the issue, mkote pa mene mkua nisa kuchita hivu. So those arguments, I think, it doesn't help. Yes, allow our brothers who are not into drama, but if you go 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 into so that you go make a difference. When we are to put it in drama situation, then drama is the government is trying by all means. Kuti njira za mene zinga leti in drama mu economy. So those who are discouraging others, I think what we can tell them, let them mind their businesses. As who want to get the money, who get it and who invest it in a manner that will help the country. I think this is what I had this year, even, comrade.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you very much. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, please.
Good evening, Mr. Tali.
Good evening.
Thank you for your program. I have a few issues I would like to highlight. One of them is the president. Very, very disappointed with the president. The president, when he took over office, before he put up his government, his cabinet, he was talking so highly how we should look forward to seeing his cabinet. And for him to hear him today start talking ill about his ministers, that is very, very embarrassing. Very, very embarrassing. And he has no one but himself to blame if he doesn't see them working so hard. There is no way he's going to run away and come out. He needs to stop this showing himself like he's the Mr. Know-it-all. I mean, people see, and I'm sure even some of his cabinet ministers are very frustrated right now. You highlighted something Anshon Temba talked about, how they have put up his portrait on tomorrow's memorial for Wakaunda. That also shows how insecure people are, that they are scared, they don't even know what to please him with. That is just making mistakes. I mean, they should be control what comes out. It's not just one person who is making a program and then voila, everything is out there. Who has not done their job? Another issue is coming to the purchases of those cars. He talked about how he doesn't want those luxury cars once he takes up office. How come we have ended up where we are today? If I were him, I would not even have mentioned it today.
You know?
Because somebody has defiled his order.
Mm.
And what we should expect from the highly HH is to fire. What he needed to do today was to fire the person who authorized that purchase, considering that he was not aware and that he doesn't belong into the purchasing department. What he needed to do was to fire so that he shows to the Zambian people that he stands by his word. Like you put it, once a car leaves a showroom, it loses value of that car. And him telling us, we won't even see who is going to buy, and those cars will be bought very, very cheaply. Mr. President, wrong, wrong, wrong. You have politicians and not leaders in your government. If you are a leader, show us today. Fire those irresponsible ministers and get leaders into government to serve the Zambian people. Politicians have no passion. Politicians are working for elections. Leaders care about generation. Zambia needs leaders and not politicians. If your politicians can't work, get technocrats to run the government with you. You can't be seen, heard all the time talking, Mr. Know-it-all. You have seen things are failing. Thank you, Mr. Tayali. Very, very frustrating. Very frustrating.
Thank you. Hello? Hello? Yeah, I'm quiet. Shanai.
If you win, we know our age mate.
Please go ahead, London.
Come and continue, please, what you are doing. Never, never, ever look back. Narana ndakufepali ya wa echechi. Shiria miyoto kawali kenya tika wakashite miyoto kanumbeshi miyoto kesho vashitile. Kwali kwete papos, esho vashitile. Nangu wama no kwe wati, wata mbupa, ama ministers wawo kukushita shirashi nesho vashitila maji X. Wama fobio kwe wati awe. Nishu wata mpo kushitile shinyoto kasumbi shesho tuwashitile tuwarashiti shakuwa ntuwabale shifura. In other way, Gavala, na totela mkwaelefu na chuma kwa kwa wati ndande kwa ufini wakaramba.
Na totela, tuwa totela. Mkwae. Hello? Hello?
Hello. Good evening, President Chitayati.
Good evening.
I want to take you back a bit when the PF lost the three by-elections that played. I want you to know that it's very difficult to win by-elections from the ruling government.
My brother,
name is Akangwa Chilesha.
Yes. Mr. Kangwa, can we talk about this in the next issue? We will be talking about that in the next issue. I think today let us concentrate on the issues that I've raised, so that people can follow properly.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Yeah. Can I say something? Chonaika in the sense that I'm a sample on they are being done in Koku in the community house. So that community house should just be turned into a masampo house.
To each in Jemma, you have masampo house, eh?
If you ever go on a masampo house, cannabis. Then you look at the so-called partial withdrawal in Avanaxa. Surely, what is 20%? And what came 20%? Now, for now, what a man, no. I wonder if civil servants in our English talk. Could have a few trundle over at you work for 7 years or 10 or 20 years so that you go out. Number, when I could pay a share, you 20%, yeah, 20 years. No, we're not pagati. What happens? Is the government going to lose out? If you do FMB, come on, VF psychology. It's a directionless government that we have. And you look at his speech. He's a blame. I'm a minister. Who appoints? Who is the appointing authority? Who is the appointing authority? The back always stops at the individual that appointed them. So you will play more or star point. Why can't you just fire them? But I'm going to go incompetent. So before you fire them, they will fire you. So this is what is going to happen, Kurie. He's going to be fired. Because you look at the faces of the ministers. You know, Achava star dress. They looked lost.
You know?
They looked lost, completely lost. They are biting, they are eating him up. I can't say much about this skeleton. Nakaraka Nakamun to Kakaka and then I got Kashan. I can call him Shadia at from Beijing.
Is it what you get from Beijing?
Kakashiro no Kakam Kusen, if you can you show up in Vamovin? So let us just get united, my brother. Let us just get united before the West goes to the West. Before we realize that we don't have a nation, we don't have a country to boast of, Zambia will be gone. Thank you, our president.
Thank you very much. Hello?
Hello. Good evening, Mr. President.
Good evening.
Thank you. I've been trying. It's congested, I tell you.
Yeah.
Our president. Our president.
Yes.
Now we sure. Balak ida shinga di afuma ku bedroom di aisa pa sitting room ni shina di bi pasana. It's like wakate pali ambu kuata ma beef na ma minister zibao.
Ai.
Ni yopo na tuchita na la.
Ai.
Ero tu. Ukwaya umuntu ukubachinga. Bena wapu ape on top of everything eba le umfuika. So mnila ka jealous in. You may think ati ni wakateka. Kashi mali kwa ta that ka inborn jealous kadia.
Ai.
Because pa kusiba I don't know. Vale la vocuela, si avovene, they are the people, avale,
Volume oxide, let's start feedback that we have a winner. We shall call volume.
Nimba Shirevo.
Oh, Nimba.
Nimba Shirevo.
Tam Nam Sperefia could be.
So, that she did put the shadow, she knows Pushara Penis, Araba, who could tell the Amanish, who did Kuchano. Natalia of the Umanish, who did the feeling to a shade, the Pirakan Sara.
Eh, Kokanian.
I always question it. tontonkanya kwa waka teka leso. Because ukokwenda valenda every day vena ni ukulu mundeke niwe mse ni ukulu mundeke niwe mbaba wama ministers wawo kwenda nshivenda po vada venda pe within Zambia ni mimo wafo kukati vali ukokuchila wombo vali pange chongo vali kwa kaputa vali pange chongo vali kuisa na kuisa evo venge minati valenda sana awe mwe wantu shuwa kachini lesa animali otola aleri otola tuchiritu lei mwena. Thank you, President.
Thank you very much. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, yes.
My president, I'm going to go to the hospital. Instruction require life. Elona mwatumwe wachi ushetani. Hapa za DNBS pa TV. Kwa hapa kona pala wabika po mtu wabaka unda. Leni vena, mairo, mumula mumula ni wabamula mbentuwa ni mumula mumula. Wabika mu picture ya ba HH. Mama isha pili ula shani. Leni ukuisa isa kuma mwachilanda fia mara nifia. Fia fia valeshi chastishefi. Amataba washitisha. Echo wa muna vichonze washitisha. Nombe vitola shana vifinshi. Na mfeli vene nepo veke para panga disutu wa kwata. Mshima washitisha fionze. Veli wese nombo fia kubule mame ima nani ama ama minister. Mwere mwere fecha. Papa esu wale pule mwa pifu. Efi wapanga chwe ni wapifu. Efi wapanga chwe wapifu. Nombo fia po fia kubule mwa pifu. But I'm not going to put my minister as well.
You are right. You are right. But I blame my PFI. No, but I'm not blame my PFI.
I'm not going to blame my minister as well.
I don't know what to blame.
No, I'm going to go to the house. 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 I'm going
to go to the Hello? 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 Yes, please. Hello? You are very low, very low. Hello? Hello?
Hey, my bunch present daddy.
Ah, buna bunch mwana waku US, eh?
USA.
Hey. Kamba mwana.
Hey, apa I present daddy tata. Ni mythomania plus amunisha tata. Hey, maze. Okay, kai chinchombia kwa tari kwa peleka makondolences kwa UPND kai naona pepa ya kumaliri wa memorial service pa referensi ya wa president so panipeleka makondolences kwa UPND wonse. Chalamba tu wa tari mamoto kameka mba wa president atu wafuna wagulisa mamoto kaya wana gulia ministers ngati wafuna kugulisa since week ni masampo sampo wafunika wabulise mazambians waka gule but not wali mkabinet minister ma cabinet ministers wao awe tufuna nai petikambia tayari ya gulapo imozi ini na gulapo imozi aliensi notu wantu wanyo wase nza UPND stipu na mtu wa UPND aliensi ya gulapo imozi so yu mkana nani kane aliensi ya seweza ni hivyo 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 kamba nzo fulache ukumbu sana nchatma yu na amini wachiko kamba wa sister wati wana amunijia manje wa wakufuwa kwa chemi thomenia. Amnesia plus mythomania tat. Ni bomu.
Zikomu. Katenji wa tayari. Zikomu. Hello? Hello?
Simbra po mkwai.
Yeah, mkwai.
Bandaivu?
Mkwai.
Mkwai, yeah. Ina chavu kuranda ku. Paiwa president yeswa. Eh, wa president la tawa sarirawa. Wa inuwaze vidya ni mwamuaka. Namba yewa ndabo kacha kulipati ya masoja. I think ama soja ewa naba tuwe kresha sana. Because ama soja, tawa kwa tama paaza kwa chiva, ya mkanya kwa president kwenda kwenda ukuru. Kwa hivyo kwa tama kwa hivyo. Hello?
Ama soja tetawa kwa tama kaya kumkanya president. Nifuwa botu inga wakanya, not ama soja.
Ama ni civilian, namba au kamu civilian ni awa civilian, asa mkupa presidenti, ambo kudrimu na ama soja.
Hello, President.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Good evening, President Tayari. Bana Kangwa here.
Yes, please, Bana Kangwa.
Yeah, I just want to make a comment on two issues. One of them is, firstly, I want to talk about the celebration of President Kaunda's death. HH is on record to say he will employ technocrats in the new Dawn administration. But when you look at what is happening, a government is a system.
Yes.
And so we would like to believe he has employed technocrats in that system. Whoever went through that program never saw that anomaly.
Imagine.
Printing of KK's birthday or memorial. First of all, I wonder what we are celebrating. Are we celebrating KK's birthday posthumously or his memorial?
Thank you very much for that question. I was also wondering umwaku Chirosha how to handle this because tomorrow it's his birthday. So I don't know what are we celebrating. Yeah. And then are we also going to gather on the day that he died, nimfurungana kona inimwe.
So, but KK never died on the 28th of April. So,
no.
I would like to believe we are celebrating
his
birthday.
Yes.
Posthumously. So, whatever the case, we needed a picture of whose life we are celebrating and remembering.
Yes.
Not the picture of the person who is hosting.
You throw a birthday party, Manakangwa. It's like you throw a birthday party for me, but the invitation cards there, it is your picture.
Exactly. So that is very wrong. Again, I would like to say this, really, we don't know whether it's the people that have taken over, the new government employees, who do not know how a government system operates, or it's the narcissistic way of by HH's handling matter. When we go to the issue of the VX, who is by HH really trying to please? Ask the Zambian people? What he needed to do was to investigate who authorized that purchase and discipline the person who did that. But alas, that cannot happen. Because when you look at some of the body language of those ministers, some of them were aggressively chewing gum.
You know? Aggressively.
Aggressively chewing gum when their leader was talking to them. For me, when you do that in front of a head of state, it's like you are telling him whatever.
Yeah, it's true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like now his own people are actually getting fed up of his rhetoric. because he is not doing anything to discipline the anomalies of all the ministers that are airing. When you look at Sylvia Masebo, you look at Mutolo Piri, you know, the list is endless. But even when the Zambians have complained, nothing has been done. It all falls on deaf ears. But he has time to reprimand us who go on social media and offer checks and balances and say we could be making money out of social media. How many people can make money out of social media? Social media for her to be making money on social media. I'm going to sound like a broken record, but I would like to say he himself got those numbers because of social media. Were all those people making money when they were praising him and talking to the masses that this is the man that we need to put on? So really, we deserve some respect from the head of state, because Ayoma bandos tulipila, tulaidipila kwewewe. We work hard to buy bundles and offer checks and balances. So we do not really need those lessons with impunity. But otherwise, as usual, Mr. Tayali, a good program. We are your listeners. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. The number that I didn't give out the number, in case some of you don't have the number is 0763-302207. For those of you that don't have the number that you call, it is on WhatsApp. If you call direct, you won't get through, but on WhatsApp only. 0763-302207 on WhatsApp only. You call on WhatsApp, not direct. You have to call on WhatsApp. That is the number that I am using. As usual, it's like, you know, when people are bashing, there is usually a network problem that comes in. And it looks like we are having that challenge right now. Balanaka, and they sort of like cut it off. Hello?
Hey,
I'm quiet.
Hey, I'm quiet. I'm quiet. Because the memory of Muntu who we movie more picture advertisement yabo. Chile pili burenji.
Ukurira pabafwa.
Takwawa uchitevyo. What does that?
Yeah. No.
Takwawa. Chena uteko uwe rangisha kwewa jao uteko ufijirwe.
No, thank you.
Ufijoku mika potwe mwene.
Thank you, mana.
Then ichichimbicha kwewa ti imi otoka vashita. Then vashitishe. Nishama sampo ya privatization ya ivengira sana mutu wa shashi.
Hello? Kanetwekinga katampo kushupa. You would be fine, but then at one point you just see the network being difficulty. Hello? Hello?
Yes, good evening.
Good evening.
How are you, sir?
Fine, thank you.
All right.
Yeah, I just wanted to say something about the president as well. Concerning all vehicles I watched today. I think if the president is a now I should be very she plus food while pandemic. What in that wash station you took her? Whether the fuck at the same stitch. Not the Rochuapa Pushokuati. Yes, she knew to get ashed. Bushetava, she will quite know to Kavarista. Because there is a budget which I'm sure. The minister or the person who was in charge produced to say, no, we need vehicles like this and that. So the
Sorry, I lost that one. Hello?
Good evening, President Anani.
Good evening.
All right, we are calling from Nairobi.
Ah, yes, it's my community.
Yes.
Yeah.
I just want to comment over the selling of government assets. You know, I believe that the government had the plan for when they were buying those vehicles, including the presidential jets.
Yes.
But now, if the president is talking about selling those assets, he needs to explain to the Zambians, if they are selling those assets at a loss or they're making a profit. If they are selling those assets at a loss, it's better they just maintain them. And who are going to buy those assets? Is there any logic in doing that? At the end of the day, the government is exposing itself, or rather the president is really exposing himself, his inefficiencies, you know? And it's kind of an embarrassment. He's just embarrassing himself and the cabinet. Otherwise, thank you very much for this forum.
Thank you.
And good night.
Good night, thanks. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Mr. Tayari.
Yes, yes, sir.
Hope you are fine.
Yes, I'm okay, thank you.
You are live, right?
Yes.
Yes, I am not sure if you are going to be able to get your talker. Because there is no way you are going to get your talker. Yes, but Banga mistake vanished. Maybe he didn't know, or maybe Patricia Vene. Then we saw Mushishitishe cheaper than Epomashishitile. The Padapomach, the people who were a brief morphine. If you were a more Pomarush. So, Mr. Diary, Gonka Niapo, the Phenomenalista. Maybe Naval Quatamano, a program in two I won't hear for some billiaco to be done with that. But otherwise, in each part, they don't know what they are doing. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, yes, sir. This is Chris calling from Copperbelt.
Okay, yes, go ahead, Chris.
Yes, yes. I just wanted to contribute because I'm done about what's about Fiabad, you know? Yeah, he's like, I believe I wasn't expecting himself to be found in the state house, you see? Because everything that he's doing, he knows. Those people who were purchasing, those who were in front, they knew what they were doing. And then they can't come today trying to impress by praising Bamjokubatota. It's all about Shishama government vehicles. They don't do that. Chimuna Munanda, Ava now Bashtiri na Lero, my Rubasango Muta. You don't do that. Because at the end of the day, Keshmina down for Yakofu. Zabantrava Furua. I was watching the way Emma Minister was like. That's not the way it's supposed to be. He needs to check himself. Not only official, we know my praise singers. Our praise singers, but in Sala, you know? It shouldn't be like that.
Thank you.
Anyway, that's my contribution.
Thank you very much. Hello? Hello?
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
This is Melvin Mwila calling from Kawe.
Please go ahead, Melvin.
President, I'm following you very well.
Thank you.
First and foremost, I want to appreciate your services. You know, we Zambians, we've learned that you've got the big heart for the people of Zambia. I just want to tackle on the issue of who the president speaking to the minister in that manner. Nanguwati ashpanganda. Ero chintina chiku varana vama. Ero vasa isa musi chivambo kura tuweba kwa tina nimo. Na ifo ni tuli involved. Kuliko fi mbi fi lech tiga. Ifo ta tuwe mwone fi ku bedroom. Parano mbachi ukushwe wale yeta wa president. Kusa muku tutanisha. Joke fi lech tiko kunishi. So, it's not a fight that I've got to put a vice for God. You have another ministers. Everybody gets your good at the survival fight. Or it's in between the Pokola and the Pochago Govati. But President Tabaranda Fishinka. No, to my son Pona to Chiramozana, Erama Moto Gavari, Kan and Yelbuksha, Bamava appears wherever the Minister of Youth and Sport, Varembano to Manimbo, in Pushtata Bemba. So to the fact that you are president, you are consistent, no further land. Umu fiasha fulayo tupela oku. Kwa kwa tiyoke mairofika chinja. Noti, each and every day, hawa kubrema na hawa kwa PF na hawa reka. Nomba pa nomba, hawa kwa kwa tushinga mabata. This time around, we are using our dream, tuwe konka. And we are a big force for president.
Thank you, my brother, thank you. Hello? 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 Hello?
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
How are you, Dr. Tai?
Fine, how are you?
Good, this is Jack.
Okay.
Calling from Salama Park.
Okay. Salama Park.
Yeah.
The land of New Kandani.
Not anymore. Yeah, you know, this government, people are talking about, has really turned things upside down. You know, I have noticed that even, you know, remember the time we had COVID? I think that time people were living a better life.
You know, you are right about that.
Yes. Yes. So those motor vehicles, I think I early noticed those vehicles, more especially on the presidential motorcade. I realized that, you know, there was sudden increase of big vehicles there. So I was asking people that, you know, this man was saying the previous government was spending a lot of money with these big vehicles and what, blah, blah. But then suddenly he came in, but I don't know, because most of the things he's doing is vice-versa, and he's doing it more than even the previous government was doing. So that, it poses a very serious question to us Zambians, because, you know, somebody who's saying there's no money in the country, but the expense has doubled, then us as Zambians, our expense of buying food and that, this has tripled. Maybe it's because he has tripled our expense, that's why they are making a lot of money to buy those big cars for them. Mm-hmm. No, so I think we just need to just to be focused, and nevertheless, we don't need to pay attention to any threat because we are a democratic country and we vote. So we just keep it calm. There will be time to come to vote. People will vote and will speak out loud so that these people, they know that, oh, these people, they were really serious because everyone is crying, but somebody say, no, you do this. No, you are just, no, you're politicking what you are wrong and the other things. There are a lot of things, actually. Mm. And wherever you pass, people are complaining. But, you know, what kind of a country is it?
Thank you, my brother. Thank you.
So, thank you very much.
Mm. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, what are you?
Yeah, I'm quiet.
I think the problem which is there now, it's money.
Hey.
You know, the IMF are not giving them the money.
Uh-huh.
And then what they did was to go and sell Amatawa, and everybody intervened. Amatawa Yapua is having to sell. Now the next thing to sell, the Mentor.
So, the MPA, they want money now.
The MPA. MPA. So after Amatawa, whatever happens, they'll sell them. From there, Katwishimbin Mandi Mayada. Thank you, boy.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I like the views that come on this program. Hello?
Hello, Mr. President.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, your line has been so busy. Been trying to get hold of you. It's easy.
Yes, it is. Mm.
Yeah, sir, this is Mavuto from within Lusaka.
Yes, yes, Mavuto.
You know what it is, most of the times when someone is dancing, the people that are watching will clap even when someone is not dancing appropriately. Mm. What I mean is that these people, they have failed, but just that they can't just come out in open to say that we have failed. They are full of experiments. I'll give an example of I was watching.
Yeah, network. Upon an issue, Paco. Your network is bad, my Mavuto. Please try again. Hello.
Good evening, President Tayani.
Good evening, sir.
How are you?
I'm okay, sir. Thank you.
I'm fine. I'm having a lot of questions. Are we here to just sell items, or maybe we are supposed to bring in new ideas on how to govern this country?
Mm.
Yeah, it's worrying. The last time it was the presidential jet, now it's the vehicles. Are we just there to sell items, or we need to bring in new ideas?
Mm.
Bana, good night.
Thank you. Hello? Hello? Okay, I think I'll leave it here for tonight. Let's leave it here for tonight. Thank you very much for joining in. Like I've said, tomorrow, let us go and support our young man, Chile One. He'll be performing tomorrow at East Park. Tickets are available. If you check online, you'll be able to see how you are able to buy the tickets. Let us go tomorrow and support the young man. After tomorrow's program, let us focus on the 27th, when Your Maps will also be performing. We need to support these guys because music entertainment is part of employment, and it is also part of our recreation. So let us support these guys. Thank you very much, and may God bless you. May God bless Zambia. Thank you.